Why are your hands blue?
I was wondering.
Look at his hands. Are they gray or blue? Are you okay?
I'm having a stroke right now. Hi, everybody. It's Judd Apatow, and this is the cast of The Bubble.
Woo!
And this is our comedy roundtable, where we will discuss comedy. Now, yeah. Leslie, you didn't really mean to go into comedy. You went into drama and got pulled into comedy. Would you say that's correct?
Mm-hmm.
Everyone just kept on laughing when you're trying to do serious scenes.
Basically what happened, they just kind of giggled at me and I didn't understand what was going on. I was being very serious and doing my best accents. And they thought it was really funny.
I think Leslie and I share the same destiny. I always consider myself as a dramatic actress.
She was being serious the whole movie.
So funny. Yeah.
When we met Harry, Harry was doing comedy on his Instagram.
I was.
And this was the first movie that you did. But what were you trying to do on your Instagram? Did you think that it was going to lead to anything, or you were just a madman in your house amusing yourself?
That's the one. It was because I didn't have like representation or anything like that, and I knew that I liked writing. And I knew that I liked kind of sketches and comedy, but the idea of doing stand-up comedy was like the scariest thing in the world. So I was like, I'm gonna do that. And so I just started doing stuff online. And then, yeah, lockdown happened, so people were just kind of trapped in front of their screens. So I was like, mwah.
What were you doing during the pandemic when you were like alone?
Sobbing gently. Many, many hours. No, I was doing like a lot of online tutoring.
I think you were still doing some tutoring during the shoot.
Yes. Oh my God, I forgot because I forgot that, right? Because I got this job like kind of out of nowhere, but I'd kind of signed up for this like longer tutoring. Cool. I'd be on my train and I felt so bad saying no. So I'd like finish in between takes and I'd do like this 45 minute tutoring and being like, so this is how you use an adverb, and just like having to do it in between takes.
I should have used you as my tutor.
You would not have passed. So.
And Sam, what was the hardest thing to do in the movie?
One of the scenes was with Leslie, who kept making me cry with laughter. They were like, action, I'll turn around, and Leslie's crying. And I'm like, yo, I can't do this. We started screaming, and then we turned around, and I could just feel her behind me, just cackling. And I'm just like this. Oh, Harry! I've lost the accent. I've gone all cockney. I'm like, Leslie, stop fucking about. But it was wicked.
And Iris, you had to dance. What was harder, shooting the dances or having to rehearse with everybody?
Rehearse, because I would get like hot flashes from panic. You always talked about how you drink a lot of Coca-Cola on set because it helps you get your energy up. So I was like, yeah. Okay, I'll do that.
And then I would be like, don't copy me.
And then I did copy you, and I just drank an entire Coca-Cola, and I was just like walking on set. And I was like, I'm just gonna do it. There's a certain point of like obvious panic when you rehearse really crazy dances like that with like, I wanted you guys to think I was talented, so I was like really going for it.
Maria, what was your favorite scene in the movie when you watched the movie?
Now when we talk about David and Leslie, even from the beginning when they said, stop it, from the very beginning. I was like, okay, I'm sold.
Stop it.
You know when we're all dancing in the background, everyone's dancing to Ladies Night?
Yeah.
There's this one bit where you called from over the systems to say, okay, Maria, go over to Pedro. And Maria just kind of like danced over. And you had to call over the system like, no, Maria, just walk, just walk. And Maria was there like,
that's hilarious.
That's
How was it for you, Karen, that there's a lot of improvisation? Have you ever worked that way before?
Never. This is my first experience of improv, and I was terrified.
So
I was like,
good.
Oh, thanks. But like, you make it easier because, you know, I feel like you don't just leave people out there on their own. Mm. So it's like, I think if somebody's struggling, you're going to give prompts and stuff, and then you know when to let other people go. Like if it's Harry, you're, you know, Samson. So it's like, I actually felt totally fine with it, like on the first day. I was like, oh, and now I don't want to work any other way. Like, I don't want to go back to normal. I love it.
Freedom is the fuck
Get out of here!
That's the cocaine talking.
Are you just riffing on Guardians of the Galaxy
yes,
every day
I,
now?
Yes, I am. Yeah, and he's embracing it.
That's dope.
I've never done that before.
Marvel forever.
Yeah, who knows if it'll make the cut, but I'm doing it.
They're like, go for it, Karen.
Yeah.
Stop rolling. Yeah.
Who is it easiest to improvise with?
Keegan is up there because he's such a yes-ander in life and on camera. Like, he's just like, yeah, I'm here for you, let's go.
Yeah.
So you feel quite safe around him, I would say.
Yeah.
Everyone, to be honest, was really great at that.
Yeah.
Fred Armisen was fun to watch.
Yeah.
There'd be something really funny for Fred to improvise. A lot of times, I just wouldn't cut.
Yeah.
Only for my own amusement.
I
was past the point where anything would be usable other than I just wanted to see where he would go if I never ever said cut for like another 10 minutes.
There was a scene where you did exactly that and you was like to Fred, just keep saying, it's gonna be great. And then Fred everyone was like, yeah, it's gonna be great.
Oh, the giggle.
And you just look around again and you can hear Judd go, all right, cut.
We'll put a cut together, it's gonna be great. We're not done. They'll probably come back.
I got kicked out of a scene once because I was crying of laughter.
I remember that.
Doing the speech, I was just like.
Yeah. Well, usually if someone's laughing, if I say, seriously, don't laugh, they get shamed, and they almost chemically stop laughing. And you.
Not this time.
You laughed, it didn't matter what I said.
There's no respect.
You and Gillan kept laughing at Fred. I was like, you're ruining the movie, and then you didn't care. You just kept laughing. And then I was like, get out of the room, and I thought you'd get mad that I said that, and then you just laughed as you walked out of the room. And Iris was supposed to be not a good actress in Cliff Beasts in the beginning.
Yeah.
And so we always tried to ask you to emphasize the wrong word.
Yeah. I love that one, that ain't no baby, is in the trailer.
That
ain't no baby!
And then my favorite is, global warming my ass!
Oh, yeah. But my favorite is, who did this? But like, the emphasis is on such a weird word.
Who did this?
Yeah.
My ass?
It's so like subtle and funny.
Did it make you want to do it, a real dinosaur movie?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I think we should make one.
Kind of make
it just makes sense.
It makes sense.
Yeah.
Should we make Cliff Beasts for real?
Yeah.
Yes.
I think we should.
Done.